Genesis 50 and verse 20. Genesis 50 and verse 20. But as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day, to save many people alive. Romans 8 and verse 28. Romans 8 and verse 28. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. Father, we thank you this morning. The cry from our heart is that you speak to us in a language that all of us can understand. In Jesus' name. Amen. I want all of us to stand. Let's sing the theme song for the providence of God. You know it? It is called Through It All. Now, today you allow Millicent to sing the stanza. Don't sing it. Even when you see it there, don't. Then I sing the stanza. Let's join in the chorus. Will that be okay?
Yes.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Jesus, and I've
voice in the house, shall we? As we appreciate and as we sit down, let's sit down with a smile to bless the name of the Lord. Providence, I said last time, one of the doctrines that people don't want to hear is that God is in control even when things are not going right. Because what we have believed is that everything has to be right. Nimeokoka nisipate taabu. That kind of a theory that we had in the early 70s. Mungu imwema, nimeokoka nisipate taabu. So when you have a problem, you think God is not involved. But God is God through it all. That we can learn to trust in God because He's God of providence. Last time we were here, we tried to give some definition, and I want to give you another one. The International Standard Bible Encyclopedia gives us the explanation of providence. It implies more than just seeing in advance. It is anticipation, causing one to take steps to meet a need through making a plan. It is, in a sense, that the prevision becomes provision. What is a vision for becomes the provision. Applies to God. Providence obviously includes the divine foreseeing, but God's foreseeing has a fuller and broader reference in view of divine overruling. Providence then is the preservation and the superintendence of all things by God. It is divine governance whereby all possible events are woven into a coherent pattern and all possible developments are shaped to accomplish the divinely instituted goal. We saw a number of things. We saw for us to understand providence, we need to know that providence it has more details, it has more things within itself. We saw that, number one, that God upholds all things. All things. There is nothing that happens without God knowing. He governs all events. He is the one who is in control of all events. So that when I am here and not there, God is still involved. A young man, hardly 6 months, falls, being held by a grandparent, and hangs on a charcoal stove. And when the grandma realizes or wakes up, the boy is dangling, the neck hanging on the stove. That young man is me. God, in His own divine way. I didn't die. Why? Because God had a wonderful plan for me. I go to Canada to study, I'm deported. With that deportation, God ordered the event. That is that God that I trust in. That is the Lord God Almighty, who, even when I'm in the storm, He is with me. When I come out of the storm, He is with me. When everything is okay, He is with me. He doesn't leave me nor forsake me, even when they sack you. God is still involved. I know our human understanding is difficult to see the providence of God and all that. No wonder some of us, after some years, you even think that you've made a mistake by the kind of wife that you have. You kind of think the husband you have is a mistake after living with that person for too long. I saw a very interesting joke of this woman that was saying, for 40 something years, I thought, yeah, she's just asking. Neither was a worker then, pay me. Because sometimes we don't see the providence of God. Sometimes we think the more we grow old, the safer we are. You're not safe until you know God is involved in many of some of these things that happen to us. Why do the righteous suffer? Why do the righteous get sick? Why? Those are questions that if you can answer them, Then you can declare like Job, I know that my Redeemer liveth when you're so sick, almost dying. I want to preach to human beings. I want to preach to people that things happen. I want to preach to people that lie. I want to preach to people that know what it means being hurt. I don't want to preach to people that when you are hurt, they don't want to associate themselves with you. God providence. It is important for us to know that God, our God, is involved. He governs all events. He directs everything to its appointed end. He knows. He governs it. He directs it. You know, sometimes you think that Kenya is under Uhuru. Uhuru has no power over this country. No wonder you read the papers, he has all the confusion. We need to pray that God gives him wisdom. Because this country is bigger than all of them put together. You know, they cannot agree. Corruption in this country, look at your neighbor, tell the neighbor. Corruption is you and me. It's we that can finish it. Don't be fooled by all that. You know, I shared a joke here one time. I used to go to a particular place for chips. Man, did I love chips and chicken. Especially the chicken that rolls itself and, you know, oh my goodness, I'll go and watch when I don't have money. So there was this restaurant that I used to go after driving my matatu to Jericho, and I'm just on my way to Banana, so I'll park my matatu haraka number one there. As it was filling up, I'll go there to have my chips. This particular restaurant, every time I asked for a quarter, they made sure they gave me a half, but covered it with a lot of chips. Amen?
Yes.
Why they did that is because I used to give tip. Even now I still give tip. But if I give tip and I realize you are, I will not come there again. Because this guy would steal from the owner. But make sure I have a half. Naibafuniko na yes vizuri. So corruption actually, can I say that? Corruption is you and me. So if you want to kill it, you cannot say, oh, you, nini malizeni. Itamalizwa namna gani, na mtu anataka kujengea choo hapa, shule. Alafu council anasema, lipwe kitu kidogo, ili akubali watoto wajengewe choo. So when the mayor became a councillor here, I said, now go there and make those toilets for us. Because donors were ready. But every time they wanted to do it, nipe kitu kidogo, nikubali mjenge choo. So when the mayor, that's why sometimes I talk to him. When he was mayor, alituwekea choo hapa, Rusambo primary choo, nyingi nzuri, na Githurai primary. Donors are there. But it's all who is corrupt. It's me. It's you. But God, hallelujah, he directs everything to its appointed end. Number four, he does this all the time and in every circumstance. There is no one circumstance that we can say God was not there. God was there all the time. Let's not miss it. God was there all the time in every circumstance. I know when it happens, and maybe the promise was so big, you know, somebody has had to promise you so much. But you know, they are human beings. And human beings can promise you heaven and not give it to you. Providence of God. Number five, we said this, he does it always for his own glory. What God does is for his own glory. Then we saw a few other things that I want to bring quickly. I don't know whether I'll be able to finish today, but whatever happens, to God be the glory. He does it for his own glory. We saw that first, these are truths that we find in God's providence. It teaches us several important truths. And one is that God cares about the tiniest details of life. Now that's why I love God. You know, there is nothing that God does not know. Every detail. People might not even know that you are hurting. But God knows. There is even now, maybe your spouse does not know what you are going through, but God does. Even the little details. Like when you are craving for mahindi ya choma. He knows. Like when you are passing by, na ile sausage iko pale ile mtura mrefu, you feel like hata kama ni size ya kisu tu, nikatue tu kidogo. Bande moja tu nikatue. You know, he knows. Even that small desire that you have, God is, you know, when I think about God, God is so good. That today here we are. Some of us, our need is 10 shillings. Others is 100. Others is 1,000. Others is a couple of thousands. Others is 1 billion. Others couple of billions. Others are billions. But God is not shaken. He looks at all of us. The one who wants 2 billion is a need. The one with 100 is a need. And God, he doesn't belittle you. Asema yako ni kidogo sana, wacha tupatie daktari yake pia kubwa. He will meet us at the point of our need. He looks, he is so concerned about the details of everything. Nothing escapes his notice, for he is concerned about the small as well as the big. In fact, with God there is no big and there is no small. He knows when a sparrow falls, he knows the number of you in your hair, even when you have shaved completely. Anajua ni ngapi. Hizo zitatoka tena unyoe, anajua. Na wale tuko na upara, anajua. Pale mwili ilipotea, anajua. Yani, he knows all those details. Do you know God is the only one you cannot lie to and pretend to and, you know, at impress? God, you cannot impress. Even if you bought a Prado, oh, no, Toyota V8, he is not amused. Now, I know when I meet you, you'll be amused. Ikikuja na Touareg mpya bwana, so you'll be amused. And ikihama nyumba niende hivi, you'll be amused. But God is not actually amused. Because where he is, he has more. Actually, he wants your faithfulness so that he can keep on giving you more. Now, that is our God. But some of us, we get 1,000 and we so celebrate that we don't wait for more. Then when the 1,000 is finished, is when we are going back to queue again. No, katalia pale. Mekupa elfu, katalia pale. Kisha aisha, katalia pale. Yani, he keeps track of the stars in the sky and the rivers that flow to the ocean. He sets the day of your birth, the day of your death. He ordains everything that concerns you that will happen in between. He is involved. Hiyo ndio ilifanya uzaliwe hiyo kabila ulizaliwa. Chameme. Na uzaliwe na hiyo baba yako. Ndio. Kama ningezaliwa nikiwa ningefurahi kwa mzungu. Too late. He knows my village. Oh my goodness, he knows my village. It might not appear in the Google map. But he knows it. Now that is our God. Awesome, isn't he? He. God of providence. He knows all that. Oh, I love him. Secondly, we also saw that he uses everything and he wastes nothing. God is not a waster. Everything. So that my life, even the bad part, he uses it. Did you know there is nothing that you have done that is not good for him? Even the worst situation you found yourself. Imagine the worst situation you found when you came out, you are crying. Even that one, God wants to use it for good for you. Now that is that God. When everybody else is condemning you, God wants that to use it so that he can honor himself. Bless the name of the Lord. I know. We're given. Kuna hadithi ya tutakage kutaja. Hata hiyo, Mungu anaitumia kwa utukufu wake. Na ndiposa ukipeana hadithi yako, history, usisahau kutaja hiyo. Najua wengine, ukiulizwa utoe ushuhuda wa karibu. Sasa nikuje niambie Uveti, tuwe na ushirika ya karibu. Sasa nimwambie Uveti, mimi niliitwa Jackie. Na nimweleze Jackie niliitwa kwa nini. Kule niseme niliiba vitu. Kwa sababu niliiba vitu. Nimwambie. Hakuna debe nilikuwa nikiona mahali na sifanye maplani yake. Hiyo debe, vile nitaamba. Hiyo debe. Yeah. Alafu sana nikisha maliza vete na hallelujah. Mimi nimekuwa mzuri sana. Nampenda Yesu. Hata siwezi kanyanga inzi. You know, the truth of the matter is, Oveti will be lying to me. Kwa sababu kama hakufanya kuimba vile niliimba, aliimba sukari ya mama. And as far as God is concerned, wizi wangu wa debe, na wizi wake wa sukari. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. So I cannot pride myself and stand here and say, mimi sijafanya dhambi ya uzinzi. Mimi niko sawa. Aha. Na ya kuchukia jina. He doesn't waste anything. Everything. You know, that's why when I give my testimony, sometimes I tell my people, ata dawa ni meuza. MB suta. Kapsu. Na nilikuwa na wateja walimu wakubwa. Kwanza walimu wangu primary wengine. Mimi ndio nilikuwa nikipelekea dawa hizi. Wauzie. Na wengine wakiwa secondary walimu wengine. Kama walimu mmoja na sitataja, alikuwa principal wa wengine wenu. Jiris. Kwa customer wangu. Alafu unasema, oh, unajua mimi sijauza madawa. Sawa. Lakini dhambi ulifanya na yangu ya madawa. Kwa Mungu. He uses everything, he doesn't waste nothing. There are no accidents with God, only incidents. This includes events that seem to us to be senseless strategies, even things that you, I tell you, huyo Mungu, ni wa ajabu, ni Mungu mkuu. Thirdly, I said this there last time, God's ultimate purpose is to shape his children into the image of Christ. Kusudi kubwa ya Mungu is to shape us to the image of Christ. And there are many verses in the Bible that teach us this truth. In the book of Acts 17 verse 28, in him we live and move and have our being. Colossians 1:17, in him all things hold together. Hebrews 1:3, sustaining all things by his powerful word. Proverbs 16:9, in his heart a man plans his course, but the Lord determines his steps. And especially Psalms 115 verse 3, our God is in heaven. He does whatever pleases him. He does whatever pleases him. The doctrine of God's providence is really a combination of four attributes of God. And I said that last time. Number one, sovereignty of God. Meaning, he is in control. I love that. The predestination. He is in charge of how everything turns out. Wisdom. He makes no mistake. Goodness. He has our best interest at heart. Then I say that God does not roll a dice. Nothing happens by chance. Ever. Nothing by chance. Hallelujah. Predestination and free will. Now, as soon as I say these words, I think someone is sure to ask about this predestination and free will. But that we might look at it at other times. But this is what I want you to carry home. He is in charge of what happens, when it happens, how it happens, why it happens. Did you hear what I say? That what you need to know is that God, he is in charge of what happens, when it happens, how it happens, why it happens, and even what happens after it happens. After it happens, then what happens? Now that is our God. And this is true of all events, it's true in every place. It is true from the beginning of time. He does this for our own good, but for his glory. He is not the author of sin, yet evil can be commanded to be used to fulfill his purpose. No wonder the Bible says, my servant Nebuchadnezzar. But when Nebuchadnezzar finished the purpose of which God had to discipline the children of Israel, even him, God dealt with him. Even evil, God can use. Evil. Nirudie tena evil. I I told you that one time I went to the U.S. and I preached a sermon. My servant Osama bin Laden. And I'm landing there when the Twin Towers have been bombed. And even some are asking, are you still flying? I say, yes. Are you not afraid of death? I say, no. Then they ask me, who are you? I say, because in Africa you can die for anything. Dead. Kufa. Ah. Ukufe kwa nja, ukufe kwa magonjo, upigwe na risasi ya mkora, ama he magaiti, yani kufa kwetu. Ati ndege unaogopa. Ndege. No problem. I will fly back home with you. Because at least, nitasafiri nazo nikakuta hazina watu. Unaenda ndege unakuta mko watu kumi. Kanatoka one city to another. And so, God is in charge. God is in charge. Even what happens after it happens. So from the beginning of time, he's not the author of sin, yet his evil serves his purpose. He's not violent. He does not violate our free will, yet free will serves his purpose. We are not supposed to understand all this. We are simply supposed to believe it. Did I lose you? I'm saying this, he does this for our good and for his glory. He is not the author of sin, yet evil serves his purpose. He does not violate our free will, yet our free will serves his purpose. We are not supposed to understand all this. We are simply supposed to believe it. So the question is, do you believe it? Do you believe it? So I hope that clears up any misunderstanding, actually, that we carry in our lives. Providence, if you want illustrations, there are many. Actually, there are so many illustrations in the Bible. I don't know whether you have read the story of Joseph. I'll come back to it. But have you read Judges? If you read Judges, you get to a guy called Samson. You remember the story of Samson? Samson one day comes to the parents. He tells the parents, I have seen a girl in Philistine. Not Dalila. I've seen a girl. And he tells the parents, nataka kuoa huyo. Now the question that I ask myself, why does he want to marry someone there? But the truth of the matter is, why was Samson born? Samson was born so that he can deliver the children of Israel from the Philistines. And for him to enter into Philistine, because they were guarded, he had to be interested in someone. Are you getting the point? So he says, I have to marry. And he goes, first of all, he doesn't marry. Did you know the story? The wife is given to somebody else. Why? So that he gets mad. What does he do? He destroys a field. Did you know also Samson has no child with those women? Did you know that? Samson had to put him to because he had no business with the children. His purpose was to accomplish something. Hata huyu Delila alimchezea mchezea akamnyoa. Jamaa akashikwa. Hata hapo amepata mtoto akashikwa. But when this jamaa is there, he calls on God. Then God comes so that he can finish his business. And when he finished, he died. But humanly, what would we argue? God, this man was a good man. He delivered us. Why did he die? He came to do what he did. And when he finished, he died. Monroe, Dr. Miles Monroe. We all know him. He came to Nairobi and he said, he is not regretting. He has done his best. In his tomb, there is nothing you go with. He has emptied himself. So he died. So what are we saying? If your dege is up, what to be nafsi? Now, what does God say? God looks at his servant and says, welcome, good and faithful servant. I know you might not even understand that. I know you might not perceive it. But that's the story of Samson. How about Ruth? Ruth, what was the purpose of Ruth? Ruth, hakuwa olewe tu, alikuwa awe nyanya ya mwokozi wetu. So, that's why Abimelech na Naomi wake lazima waende huko. Are you getting the point? And then huko, so I know we preached so many sermons from there, but one of the sermons that you need to carry is this. Ruth could not have come to Bethlehem if Abimelech did not go. So hunger and famine was for them to go there so that they come with Ruth and everything. Have you read, at the right time, he goes to the right place. At the right time, he's lived in the right place. At the right time, he calls unto Boaz. And finally, the lady that said, don't call me Naomi, call me Mara. Every woman in the city, they are rejoicing and blessing the Lord. That's Ruth. That was his destiny. How about Joseph? Maybe Joseph will help us because of where we started. He said, Joseph is calling his brother and says, am I in the place of God? Maybe now he's a poor man, Pamungu. Can I be the place of God? Then, full stop, he tells them, what you meant for evil, God meant it for good, so that I can save many and save you. The story of Joseph is a very good example. Very, very good example for us. And I pray that we can pick something from there. Many things happened. Many things happened about Joseph. Let me go back and read 19 and 20 of Genesis 50. Don't be afraid, Amor. Am I in the place of God? You intended to harm me, but God intended for good to accomplish what is now being done. The saving of many lives. The saving of many lives. The King James translates this verse 20 this way. You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. Both the sides of that statement are true. You meant it for evil. Period. What the brothers had done was indeed evil. Period. Nimbaya. Hakuna mahali pa kurejoice pale. Nimbaya, they did evil. Joseph does not sugarcoat the truth. He tells them what you did is evil by itself. You planned evil. That's it. They are 100% responsible for their sin. But he turns around and said, God meant it for good. But you see, what God meant for good did not show up immediately. It came up after a long time. So Joseph saw the invisible hand of God at work in his life. He understood that behind his conviving brothers stood the Lord God, who had ostracized the entire affair in order to get him to just the right place at just the right moment in order to save his whole family. Now I want you to follow this, because if you miss it, you will not understand the providence of God. Joseph takes food to his brothers. I want to say, at the right time. Because when he gets there, they plan to kill him. But they argue among themselves because he went at the right time. You know, when you appear at the right time, your enemy does not know what to do. So he appeared at the right time. They don't know what to do with him. But one of them suggests, there is a well here which is dry. Let's throw him there, let him die. So the well is dry because he came at the right time. He is thrown there to die at the right time. So when he lands there at the right time, the Midian, they are passing that place at the right time. And so one of them suggests, instead of our brother dying, please, let's sell him to these people. How do they know those people are selling? Those were merchants. So they sold their brother at the right time. Then Joseph is taken to a marketplace. And you know, in the marketplace, anybody could have come to buy Joseph. But nobody did, because Potiphar came at the right time and bought Joseph. Now I want you to see the sequence. Joseph is bought at the right time by Potiphar. And he goes as a slave, but he grows up, becomes the head of all the staff there. He is the boss. So at the right time, he becomes the boss. And you know what? As he did whatever he did, glory and honor was upon him. You know, somebody said that Sometimes you have to be careful because even as you grow old, you also become handsome. So Joseph, as he was doing his work, when he was doing his business, he did it so well. The wife of Potiphar at the right time. Not before. At the right time. He admires her. So one day at the right time, he got hold of her. He runs away. She screams. Joseph is caught. Now I want to tell you, there were many prisons in Egypt. Please follow. There are many prisons in where? In Egypt. But because he was at Potiphar's house, he cannot be put in any prison. Are you seeing the providence of God? He is not put in committee. He is put a good place. Because he is at the right time. So when he is thrown in a prison where the king's staff, corruption, they had their own prison. And you know God is so good because he was preparing for something big. Even there, those senior people, after a while, Joseph becomes their boss. Can you see that? He is prepared for something else. What you meant for evil, God meant it for good, but you have sinned. That will be fine. Yule alikutendea maovu, alifanya maovu, alitaka uwe na maovu, na kukuharibia jina na sifa, lakini Mungu anatumia yale maovu, ili aweze kujitukuza Bwana Yesu kwa sifa. So at the right time he's thrown there. Why I'm saying at the right time? Because after a couple of years, the king has a problem with his senior guys. Two of them. They are thrown in there. Moja ni yule anaangalia mvinyo. Na mwingine ni yule anakoka mikate wakatupwa kule. Si wamekumkuta Joseph. Wakaota ndoto. Thank God for people who dream. Wakaota ndoto. Ikawasumbua. Wakaulizana sasa tutafanya nini? Joseph akawaambia, "Hizi ndoto ziko namna hii. Wewe after 3 days wewe utatolewa hapa. Lakini ndege utakula nyama yako wewe. Utakatwa kichwa. Na wewe siku tatu zikiisha utaitwa. Mfalme atakuita wende umfinie mvinyo tena. Sasa jameni, ukifika huko, si utanikumbuka." But I want to tell you this. If he was remembered immediately, Joseph would not have become the prime minister. I want to talk to you. It has to be at the right time. So he forgets Joseph. But at the right time, when Pharaoh has a dream, he remembers Joseph. He remembers Joseph. So what does he say? There is a guy in there. A prisoner. If you read the story, it will also tell you something. When they were bringing him to the king, Akumuleta na kuza prison, they washed him clean. Hata kama huko prison. Alioshwa vizuri. Kwa sababu it is a there. And then he goes before the king. Hey, ana kiherehere. Hata hakujua atakuwa prime minister. Lakini ndoto yake ili alikuwa ameota bado haiozi. Mwambie jirani yako ndoto haiozi bwana. Kama ni ya Mungu haiozi. That's the God that we trust in. Whether I'm down, he will lift me up. My enemy, please don't rejoice over me. Because when I fall, I wake up. I can fall 7 times. But every time I fall, I'm going to wake up. That's my God. So he tells Pharaoh the dream. At the right time. And because it was the right time, the king had hakuwa na wakati wa kutafuta mtu mwingine. Sijui kama umeenda kuongea na your boss, umeomba mawaidha, akwambia hiyo position ya kuku wako, but we are going to create it for you. I know some of you don't do those things. But you can start now telling your boss some of the dreams. How you think the job can work. And I know a guy who was a Form 4. And in his CV today, he has been a senior manager in one of the big firms in the city. Because he went and told the managers there, "I have come to help you." Then they wakamuuliza namna gani. Simu hapa, simu. Haitalia mara tatu. Takuwa ikilia mara moja inachukuliwa. You know, Mzungu anaangalia huyu jamaa. Sasa kwani ni majiki gani? Anasema nipe kazi. Nipe kazi akafanywa manager.
manager, senior manager.
Na kweli simu ilikuwa ikilia, hailii mara tatu.
Wakafanya kazi kwa muda, haendelea.
Na sasa ni msini ya mahali. Kwa sababu ndoto. Mimi mwona kama Joseph. He knows how to interpret what he sees around. Very, very quickly if I can. And I'll try to. Because today I thought I'll come and finish. What are some of the implications of God's providence? What are some of the implications of God's providence? Very quickly, number one, providence frees us from bitterness. Bitterness. Providence frees us from bitterness. This is clear the message of Genesis 50:20. If every angry, if any man had the right to act even harder, it was Joseph. We get bitter because we doubt God's goodness. And we don't see his invisible hand at work in our lives. We think God isn't involved in our situation, and that's why we get angry and we try to get even and we want to hurt people that have hurt us. If you really believe God is at work in your situation, you can just stand back and let God do whatever he wants to do. If you believe in God's providence, it will protect you from being angry. Because what is meant for evil, God can use it for it. And that's what he's going to do. So, Isaac a teacher here. Right? Isaac a teacher. Kwa sababu ameshindwa na kazi. Oh my goodness. Anatoka hapa. Anaanza shule yake. Inakuwa competitor wa hii yetu. Tukikutana nakuja hapa kutoa sadaka na niambia Bishop, asante kwa kunifuta. No, let's listen. Are you sure nilipo mfuta alifikiria hivyo? Hapana, alilia kwa ofisi yangu. Lakini alipotoka akajipa moyo na vipawa vyake na karama zikazuka. Kaanza shule sasa zina compete. Sasa mimi nilimprovoke. And all what I did was to sack unfaithful and productive teacher. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
So some of you, you are sacked because you are unproductive, you are unfaithful. Today, you own your own business. May God sack some more. Because some of us will never, as long as we have not been shaken, will never. Lakini ulipofutwa ulisikiaje? Mbaya sana, hata pasta ukamwambia wamenionea. Kweli kabisa walinionea. Kwanza hao ni makabila, ni wakikui walinionea. Kwanza wakinifuta waliongea kikui. Najua. But if you look back and you say, thank God, they sacked me. Thank God they chased me. You know, I went to do masters in one place. And at least, actually, they just did not want me. I got 2 pieces. They said you have to do something. Fanya course moja tuone kama unaweza. Then I got zote BB. Alafu mwalimu kwa nasema wewe. Lakini ni history because I used to work there. Ni history. Sasa walipoangalia majina yangu ni history tu. Wakakata. The kind of history nikasoma na nikamaliza. And I was always in the dean's list. Now when there, they called me. Hey, Jimmy, come. I said, I come? Thank God you chased me. All things work together for good, but it is to them that are called. If you know the providence of God, itakuokoa kutoka hasira. Amen. Number B. Providence gives us a new perspective on our tragedies. That perspective might be stated this way. God is involved with us even in the worst moments of life. I believe that in the great issue of life, we will generally not have an answer to the question, why did this happen to me? That is, we won't know why our mate got sick. We will not know why we lost our life saving. You know why these
hiyo kitu ya destiny kadhalika. Why
God did you not intervene? Why did you not show me? Why did you not shake me to know that this thing is dying? We will not understand. Why God did you not intervene when we were being sexually abused?
But most of the time, we are simply left to wonder why these things happen. Who would dare to say to a woman, this is why your child died stillborn? Or to the grieving people, this is why your husband has died. Can we? We can't. So what do? We leave you with your questions. But if all things work together for good, he will bring the good at the right time. Hallelujah. I would rather we pray. You know, there are still 3-4 others, but I would rather we pray. I want to ask the ministry team to come and pray. Because I feel there are some people here. Actually, where you are, the questions that you have no answer. Because actually some of you have been thrown in a pit to die. Some of you, whatever people are saying about you, it's not for you to prosper. Some of you have questions that actually have no answer. Why me? Why me? And I think we need to pray for some of you. If that is where you are, oh, the Lord does not care for me. Why did he allow this to happen? Why am I in this situation? Why am I suffering and struggling? Why have I repeated this exam for too long? Why? Why are these things happening? Why can't I prosper? I had good business. What is happening? Why? Why is this happening? If you find yourself there, please, I want you to come quickly. We will not be here for too long. But we want to pray with you in the mighty name of Jesus. So that God can help you to see, is this the right time? Or you went there earlier? Are you doing it? Or would you want God to turn it around for you? Because God can. We'll sing through it all again. Please come and join with someone. Because I believe there is somebody here that need God to deliver. You are bitter because of what has happened. You have no proper perspective of the tragedy that is happening to you. But it is at this point that God's providence is so crucial when you're asking those questions. It doesn't tell us everything we would like to know about the mysteries of life, but it does assure us that God is there and that he cares for us. He is somehow involved even in our darkest moment, in a way we cannot see and probably wouldn't understand even if we could see. Because of God's providence, we can keep believing in God even in the face of many unanswered questions. He can bear the burden of all our answered questions. Hallelujah.
Through it all, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus, and I've learned to trust in God.
Through it all,
through it all,
through it all,
I've learned
Oh,
are falling from us. You know the pains that we are going through. We thank you that you don't only see the tear, but you hear us when we call. Hearken unto our cry this morning. Lord God, what is meant for evil, Lord God, may it work for good. May it work for good. May it work for good. May it work for good.